Listen. Listen clearly. I'll give you the example. There is someone. If you give $1 million for a project, trusting him, he will make it into $1 billion. But he may take 1 million or 2 million in a non-integrated way from that project. I will never bother about the billion he will bring in. No. I'll simply say, no, stop. But the same person says, give me $1 million. I'll make this project into $1 billion. And you give me 10 million as a salary. I will immediately say, yes, okay, go ahead. Let us put the whole thing in contract. Write it, pen it down. Take the million, do the project. Take the 10 million. I'll be absolutely okay with it and go for the expansion. Listen, adopt the same principle in your life. You will be successful forever. I learned this one lesson very strongly. Listen. I have various levels of gurus in my life. There were some of my gurus who just predicted I am going to come. The incarnation is going to happen. And before even I came, they left the body. But they were also reason for my incarnation. There are other gurus who predicted I am coming, and the moment they made sure that I am safely landed and they saw me as a baby, then they said, yes, now things are done. They left the body. Like Pundi Swamigal, Pundi Atri Swamigal, he just waited for me to land and settle down in the body. After I was born, I was taken to him. He confirmed and that his father has landed and everything is going well. He just said, my job is done, and he left the body. There are some other gurus who made sure I settled into the body and start manifesting nicely, and made sure I have reached the non-return zone. I won't fall anymore into human zone. I have gone beyond the human zone. And then they left the body. Isakki Swamigal. He realized I have started flowering and I have gone to non-return zone. Nothing to worry anymore. And he left the body. After making sure. I think by 1991 he left the body. Pundi Swamigal left the body in 1978 itself. That same year I assumed the body. He left the body. After making sure I have settled and everything is okay, and he left the body. Then there are some gurus who continuously monitored and guided, gave instructions how I should be brought up. Like Kanchi Paramacharya, continuously he has given instruction to 230th Guru Mahasannidhanam of Tonde Mandala Adhinam, who was my grandfather and my guru. There are some other gurus who made sure I have fully flowered and then left the body, like Kuppammal and Raghupati Yogi, all of them. They made sure I have fully flowered and then they left the body. There were some other gurus who made sure I have started my public life actively. Only then left the body. Yogi Ram Surat Kumar. He waited till I came back to Thiruvannamalai and gave him the assurance that I am continuing the spiritual mission and everything is well. All is well and it is happening. And then only he left the body. In 2000, he left the body. Understand? I am telling you batch by batch. Kuppammal, Raghupati Yogi, Annamalai Swamigal. All of them left the body almost at the same time, in 1 or 2 years. And then the next. After made sure that I am successful. Only after I started the public life, everything is okay. Visari Swamigal, Yogi Ramsarathmar left the body. There were few gurus made sure even in my public life mission, everything is going well. I have been given continuous guidance and instruction. Only after they were assured everything is going well, they left the body. That is Tiruchi Swamigal. Tiruchi Swami left the body only in 2005. Till then, regularly, I myself will go and fall at his feet and ask for guidance. And or he will call, he will send his disciples and call me. There are so many witnesses in Bangalore even now. He will send some of his disciple Chettiars and tell them, hey, tell Swamiji to come. When I go there, he will ask about every detail and he will instruct me.